comes sa itong Sunday night service. Umpisa na itong panimbangang piyagas sa pagkanta. Let's praise the Lord as we sing this song, Follow On. Patayon ta sa pagsunod sa itong buhay ng Diyos na si Jesus Cristo. Follow on! Down in the valley with my Savior I would go, where the flowers are blooming and the sweet waters flow. Everywhere He leads me, I would follow, follow on, walking in His footsteps till the crown be won. Follow, follow, I would follow Jesus, anywhere, everywhere, I would follow on. Follow, follow, I would follow Jesus, everywhere He leads me, I would follow on. Down in the valley with my Savior I would go, where the storms are sweeping and the dark waters flow. With His hand to lead me, I would never, never fear. Danger cannot frighten me if my Lord is near. Follow, follow, I would follow Jesus, anywhere, everywhere, I would follow on. Follow, follow, I would follow Jesus, everywhere He leads me, I would follow on. Down in the valley or upon the mountain steeps, close beside my Savior would my soul ever keep. With His lips in the path that He has trod, up to where they gather on the hills of God. Follow, follow, I would follow Jesus, anywhere, everywhere, I would follow on. Follow, follow, I would follow Jesus, everywhere He leads me, I would follow on.
Thank you so much, Brother Davy. At this time, mo add to ta sa pag-ampo. And please add this request sa inyong mga list. Please pray para sa Bajau family, sa taga-uhaw ni sila, namatay ang mother. So please pray sa Bajau family. Also, please pray kay Mrs. Segura sa Australia. Karoon siya og a mild stroke, so please pray for her. Also, please pray for John Pandian. Siya ay spine problem, one of the relatives ato ang church member. So please pray kay John Pandian. So karon mag-aampo kita. Let's pray. Father in heaven, salamat kaayo Ginoo karon nga gabi. Thank you Lord God sa opportunity Ginoo nga maka simba, maka kanta diha sa imuha, maka dai Ginoo sa imong ngalan. And Lord, gusto namo Ginoo nga through this program ikaw ang mahimaya Ginoo, imong name mag-glorify. And Lord, sa karing program Ginoo tonight, as we spend our time Ginoo sa pagpaminaw sa imong pulong, nag-aampo kami nga ikaw mag-speak Ginoo sa mga kasing-kasing Holy Spirit, ikaw mag-convict sa mga if there are sins sa among heart Ginoo nga dapat na mo i-get right, i-confess diha kanimo, ikaw mag-istorya ka na mo Ginoo, help us to be willing to forsake it. And Lord, if there are things Ginoo sa among life nga nag- pabugat Ginoo sa pagpangalagad sa imuha, help us Lord, i-correct na siya Ginoo or i-set aside na siya Lord God. Lord, gusto na mo Ginoo, pinaagi si mong pulong tonight, ikaw Ginoo mag-istorya ka na mo and make us better Christians Ginoo by making commitments and deciding Lord God sa paghatag Ginoo sa mong tibuok magkinabuhi diya kanimo Ginoo. And Father, bless the preaching karon nga gabi, bless the rest of the program. Bless your people. Maningin na po namo in Jesus' name. Amen. After this, ang ginahangyo balik si Brother Davy. And after Brother Davy, na ate isa ka special. And tonight, ang mag-speak para sa atua will be Pastor Orlando, one of our associate pastors sa Mount Calvary. And he'll be speaking after this special.
May gabi ulit sa tanan. Ato ni pakantahon, I know whom believe it. Salig ta, tira kang Kristo. I know whom I have believed.
I know that why God's wondrous grace to me He had made known, nor why unworthy Christ in love redeemed me for He I've committed unto Him against that day. I know not how the Spirit moves, convincing men of sin, revealing Jesus through the Word, creating faith in Him. But I know whom I have believed, and I'm persuaded that He is able to keep that which I've committed unto Him against that day. I know not when my Lord may come at night or noonday prayer, nor if I walk the pale with Him or meet Him in the air. But I know whom I have believed, and I'm persuaded that He is able to keep that which I've committed unto Him against that day.
Amen. Good singing. And this time, I may not take special.
About them, the disciples were afraid, for the waves were high and the ship was tossed. They could not find their way. Then they awoke the master, saying, "Lord, please save us now." He rebuked the winds and the sea grew calm, and they all wondered how
God sees the storm from the other side. He knows the lessons learned, and just beyond the clouds He sees clear skies. He speaks peace to the raging storm when peace cannot be found. He already sees the rainbow when we see only clouds. Like the man on the sea did, I have called on God in prayer. When it seemed to me all hope was gone, and in my deep despair,
I remember what the Lord said when He calmed the troubled sea.
And I know once more how He sees the storm, and peace floods over me. God sees the storm from the other side. He knows the lessons learned, and just beyond the clouds He sees clear skies. He speaks peace to the raging storm when peace could not be found. He already sees the rainbow when we see only clouds. And when the storms of life come crushing in to trouble me, I can feel God's arms around me, and He whispers, "Let it be. From the other side, He knows the lessons learned,
just beyond the clouds he sees clear skies. He speaks peace to the raging storm when peace could not be found. He already sees the rainbow when we see only clouds.
So good evening to everyone. So let us open our Bible in the book of Galatians chapter 2. Galatians chapter 2. This is Apostle Paul writing to the believers, to his church at Galatia. Paul is reminding his church or his converts about the false teaching that is coming in into his church, because people will be confused because of these false teachings that are spreading. So Paul is warning his people to watch out for these false teachers, false teaching about the gospel, false teaching about salvation. I will read chapter 2, book of Galatians chapter 2, verse 5. To whom we gave place by subjection, no, not for an hour, that the truth of the gospel might continue with you. In verse 14, but when I saw that they walked not uprightly according to the truth of the gospel, I said unto Peter before them all, thou being a Jew livest after the manner of Gentiles, and not as do the Jews. Why compellest thou the Gentiles to live as do the Jews? Another verse, chapter 1, book of Galatians, verse 6. Marvel that you are so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Christ unto another gospel. Verse 7. Which is not another, but there is some that trouble you and would pervert the gospel of Christ. Verse 9. As we said before, so I say now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you than that you have received, let him be accursed. Let us go to Romans chapter 1, verse 14 to 16. This is about the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Chapter 1, verse 14, Romans. I am debtor both to the Greeks and to the barbarians, both to the wise and to the unwise. So as much as in me is, I am ready to preach the gospel to you that are at Rome also. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation, to the Jew first, to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. Let us pray. Almighty God, Father, Lord, we thank you sa Bible. Thank you, Lord, that the Bible will tell us the truth. I pray, Lord, that you'll bless this message. Help me, Lord, to deliver this message. May you be honored and glorified in Jesus' name. Amen. So mga igsoon, my dear friends who are watching and listening this program tonight, the message tonight, the truth of the gospel. The truth of the gospel. God wants us to know the truth. The truth in John chapter 8, verse 32, Jesus said, and you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Religion can be wrong, but the Bible will always tell us the truth, because the Bible is the perfect word of God. Man can be religious without knowing the truth. We can all be religious without knowing the Bible, without knowing the truth. In Romans chapter 3, verse 4, the Bible tells us, let God be true, but every man a liar. We can have the truth because we have the Bible. Religion will tell us many things, but religion is man-made, and man can be wrong. So we need the truth. So the title is The Truth of the Gospel. What is the gospel? In 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 1 to 4, we can see the definition or Paul's description of what is the gospel or about the gospel. Let us open our Bible in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 1 to 4. The Bible tells us, Paul said, moreover, brethren, I declare unto you the gospel which I preach unto you, which I preach unto you, which also you have received, and wherein you stand, by which also you are saved, if you keep in memory what I preach unto you, unless you have believed in vain. Verse 3, for I delivered unto you, first of all, that which I also received, how that Christ died for our sins, according to the Scriptures. Verse 4, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day, according to the Scripture. So the gospel is the death, burial, and the resurrection of the Lord Jesus Christ. The gospel, the word gospel also means good news. It is the good news of salvation. So first of all, the truth of the gospel. Number one, salvation comes by receiving the gospel. Last August of 1998, when I was 36 years old, somebody explained to me the Bible, how to be saved. An American missionary told me or explained to me how to be saved. I realized that I am a sinner. I realized that because I am a sinner, I am bound for hell. I realized that God so loved me so much. God loves me that he sent his son, the Lord Jesus Christ. A sinless, Christ is a son of God. He is sinless. He suffered. He shed his blood on the cross. He died. He was buried and rose again. On August 1998, I put my faith on the Lord Jesus Christ and I received him as my personal Savior. So last August of 1998, I received the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ when I put my trust on him. So salvation is by receiving the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. There are several passages to tell us about Christ, the gospel. John chapter 3, verse 16, very common to all of us. The Bible tells us, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. The key word in this verse is believe. The word believe means to trust, to rely, to depend. To whom? That is Jesus Christ. Believe means in him, in Christ, that you believe in him on what he did on the cross. He suffered, he shed his blood, he died, he was buried, and rose again. So believe means that is believing on the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Also, in Acts chapter 16, verse 31, we will not open in that verse, but the story tells us the Philippian jailer asking Paul and Silas, he asked, what must I do to be saved? Paul and Silas said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Believe means to trust Christ on what he did on the cross, that he is a sinless Son of God. He suffered, he shed his blood, he died, buried, and rose again for our sins. So that is the gospel, believing on the Lord Jesus Christ. In 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 15, 1 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 15, I will read this verse. This is about believing or being born again. Chapter 4, verse 15. 1 Corinthians chapter 4 and verse 15. Paul said, for though you have 10,000 instructors in Christ, yet have you not many fathers. For in Christ Jesus, I have begotten you through the gospel. I have begotten you through the gospel. Paul was writing to the believers at Corinth. So, ingon si Paul, I have begotten you through the gospel. The Bible tells us that you must be born in order to see the kingdom of God. Once you receive the gospel, you become a child of God. You are born again Christian. That is through the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. So, there is no other gospel. Paul also said in Galatians 3:26, for you are all the children of God by faith in Christ Jesus. By faith in Christ Jesus, that means by faith that you believe in Christ, that he is a sinless Son of God. He suffered, shed his blood, buried, died, buried, and rose again for our sins. For we become a child of God because we believe the Lord Jesus Christ. When we receive the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ, we become a child of God. So Paul said, there is no other gospel. There is no another gospel. Some says that faith in Christ plus good works. No, that could not bring a salvation. Paul said that is another gospel. Others said that faith in Christ plus good works plus baptism would bring salvation. Paul said that is another gospel, and that could never give us salvation. In Acts chapter 4, verse 12, the Bible tells us, neither is there salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Notice the word name. No other name, that is the name of Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ is the Son of God. He is sinless. He suffered. He shed his blood. He died. He was buried and rose again. So there is no other salvation apart from the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. So salvation comes by receiving the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Open your Bible. If you have your Bible, again, let us open Romans chapter 10, verse 14. Romans 10, 14. Again, this is a very common passage to believers. Romans chapter 10 and verse 13. The Bible tells us, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Verse 14. How then shall they call on him, that is Christ, in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him, of whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? Romans 10, 17. So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Number two, the truth of the gospel. First of all, salvation comes by receiving the gospel. Number two, the lost needs to hear the gospel. They need to hear the gospel. Our faith should not come from the people. Our faith should not come from any religion. Religion may say many things, but our faith should not come what religion says. Our faith should not come what people say. Our faith should come from the Word of God, and that is our faith. Religion may confuse us, and many people today are being confused because they listen to religion. They listen to man-made teaching. Faith, the lost needs to hear the gospel. In 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 3 and 4, the Bible tells us a lost person is blinded with the gospel. 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 3. Chapter 4, 2 Corinthians, verse 3 and 4. The Bible tells us, but if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world, that is Satan, hath blinded the minds of them, which believeth not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. My dear brothers and sisters, lost people are blinded with false teaching. Many people today are blinded by Satan. They are blinded by their tradition. Many people today are blinded by the wrong teachings of their religion. Before I got saved, I thought being religious, I can go to heaven. Before I got saved, I thought giving my money to the church could give me salvation. I thought confessing my sins could give salvation. But it is not. I was blinded by Satan. We as believers, we have the gospel light, and we need to give and tell those who are in darkness. Satan's work is for us to be confused. Satan do not want us to be saved. If you are lost, Satan does not want you to be saved. That's why many people are blinded by Satan, by their religion. They are blinded by tradition and other false teaching. We must give or tell other people about the gospel, because lost people go to hell. According to the statistics, in every second, two people die. That means in every minute, there are about 100 people die. And according to statistics, out of 10, only one is saved. Only one has received the gospel. Only one is going to heaven. Out of 10, that is the statistics. So it is very sad that many people until today did not hear the gospel. So they need to hear the gospel. As Christians, we must tell them the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. And then number 4, and then second, in Romans chapter 1, verses 1, 14 to 16, I will read this again. Romans chapter 1, verse 14 down to 16. This is one of the greatest statements of the Apostle Paul. Apostle Paul is the missionary. He is the one who is responsible of giving out, bringing the gospel to outside the Jewish community. Peter was responsible to give out the gospel in the Jewish community. Paul's mission that God had given him is to bring the gospel outside the Jewish community. That's why Paul brought the gospel to Asia, Paul brought the gospel to Europe, to America, and to other countries like Philippines. So I will read this again. Romans 1:14, Paul said, I am debtor both to the Greeks and to the barbarians, both to the wise and to the unwise. So as much as in me is, I am ready to preach the gospel to you that are at Rome also. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. Number 3, the truth of the gospel. First of all, salvation comes by receiving the gospel. Number 2, the lost needs to hear the gospel. And then number 3, saved people are responsible to proclaim the gospel. Paul said, I am debtor. I am debtor. If Paul is a debtor, we are also debtor. Because we have the gospel message, we have a great responsibility to proclaim the gospel to the lost. Our part, our part is to tell or proclaim the gospel. God's part is the salvation or the saving part. It is not our ability, it is not our talent, it is not our wisdom, and it is not our education. Because the Bible tells us the gospel is the power of God. It is the power of God. Sometimes, makaingon ta, I am not educated, I am not talented, I am not a good speaker, but we have the gospel, and the Bible tells us the gospel is the power of God unto salvation. All we have to do, our part, is to give out the gospel. In 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 17 and 18, I will read 1 Corinthians chapter 1. Paul said, verse 17, For Christ sent me not to baptize, but to preach the gospel, not with wisdom of words, lest the cross of Christ should be made of none effect. Verse 18, For the preaching of the cross is to them that perish foolishness, but unto us which are saved, it is the power of God. So maybe makasultita, we can say that we are not a good speaker, we are not talented, we are not educated. But Paul said, it is the power of God. The gospel is the power of God. The Bible tells us, to the lost, to them that perish, that means to the lost, the gospel is foolishness. That's why when we speak or when we witness, when we give out the gospel to the lost, sometimes lost people will persecute us. They would not listen. Katauan lang ta nila. Because to them, to the lost, it is foolishness. But to us, it is the power of God. So our part is to give the gospel. It is God's responsibility. The saving part is for our Lord Jesus Christ. So to the lost, it is foolishness. But to us, it is the power of God unto salvation. Paul also said, I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. We should not be ashamed to give out the gospel. Anywhere we go, we must give the gospel. Tell the people about Christ. Tell about salvation through the Lord Jesus Christ. In the market, tumatag palingki, or any place. In buses, we can give out the gospel. We should not be ashamed. In our workplace, we should not be ashamed to give out the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Because it is the power of God. To the rich, to the politicians, to the poor, to the educated, we must give out the gospel. We should not be ashamed because it is the power of God unto salvation. Maybe, ikaw, new believer, you are a new convert, just give the gospel. Share your testimony. Give out gospel truck. That is the first step how to be a soul winner. Go to Christians who had been witnessing for a long time. Mag-uban ka sa mga dugay na Kristuanon nga dugay na naga-witness. Dugay na sila nga tighatag pirmi sa mensahe sa kaluwasan, which is the gospel. That is the first part how we can be a soul winner. How to give out the gospel and win the lost to Christ. Saved people should not hinder the gospel. In 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 12, I will read this passage. 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 12. Paul said, if others be partakers, this power over you, are not we rather? Nevertheless, we have not used this power, but suffer all things, lest we should hinder the gospel of Christ. Then, under this subject, save people who are responsible to proclaim the gospel. That means, as believers, we should not hinder the gospel. Paul is telling here in this verse, in 1 Corinthians 9:12, Paul said that he would not do anything to hinder the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Don't you know that we as Christians, sometimes we hinder the gospel? If Christians are not living right, if Christians are living in sin, we hinder the gospel. That's why many lost people will not get saved, because they see in our life that our life is not right with the Lord Jesus Christ. If lost people will see us living in sin, we hinder the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. In 1 Corinthians 15:33, Paul said, awake to righteousness and sin not, for some have not the knowledge of God. Some don't know Christ. Some are not saved. That's why Christians, we are to live right, awake to righteousness and sin not, for some have not the knowledge of God. I speak this to your shame. Christians are living in sin, who are living in sin, is a shame to God because we hinder the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. In Colossians chapter 4, verse 5, Paul said, walk in wisdom toward them that are without. The word without in this verse is referring to the lost. They are without Christ. They are without the gospel. Walk in wisdom toward them that are without, redeeming the time. Your lost relatives and friends, sometimes they will not listen to you when you tell them about the gospel, about salvation, about the Lord Jesus Christ. Why? Because if our life is not right with God, if we are living in sin, we hinder the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. In Philippians chapter 1, verse 12, Philippians chapter 1, verse 12, Paul said, the furtherance of the gospel. Philippians chapter 1, verse 12. I will read. Paul said, but I would you should understand, brethren, that the things which happened unto me have fallen out rather unto the furtherance of the gospel. The furtherance of the gospel. I will read again. Philippians 1, 12. But I would you should understand, brethren, that the things which had happened unto me have fallen out rather unto the furtherance of the gospel. Paul is telling his fellow believers that the things that had happened to him, the persecutions, the hardships, the difficulties that Paul has encountered or had experienced in his life as a missionary, these things, God allowed it, and Paul was willing to suffer for those things. Paul was persecuted. Paul was imprisoned twice. Paul experienced shipwreck. Paul was beaten unto death, and almost he died because he was beaten for preaching the gospel, for giving out the gospel. We as believers, we should be willing to sacrifice, to suffer for the furtherance of the gospel. We are saved, we are bound for hell, for heaven, I mean. A saved person, God has promised us that one day we will be in heaven. That is the greatest promise of God. That's why if there are difficulties or hardships, afflictions in our life, we should continue giving out the gospel because we have the responsibility. Paul said, I am debtor, both to the Greeks, to the barbarians. That means to any kind of person. Greeks are people who are well-to-do. Barbarians are the lowest, the less civilized people during the time of Paul. But Paul said he is willing to give out the gospel. He is debtor both to the Greeks, to the upper class, to the barbarians, to the wise, and to the unwise. For as much as in me is, that is the gospel, I am ready to preach the gospel to you that are at Rome also. We as believers, we are responsible to preach the gospel, to give out the gospel, to witness to the lost. Those who are rich, those who are poor, those who are educated, less educated, we are responsible. We are debtor because we have the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. So there is the so-called furtherance of the gospel. We as believers, we should be willing to give and sacrifice for the furtherance of the gospel. We are to give our money for the furtherance of the gospel. The Bible teaches us, and in our churches, we are commanded to give our money for the gospel. And that is called missions. That's why we have a missions giving. We have the tithes. The first 10% of our income, ibalik natin sa Diyos. And then the remaining 90%, we will give that for the furtherance of the gospel. That is sacrificial giving. That is grace giving. Why? Because many people have never heard the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. In our locality, in our own area, there are many people who needs to hear the gospel. And as Christians, we are responsible to give them the gospel. In the foreign land, Jesus said his command in Mark 16:15, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. All of us, we cannot go, but we can give our money for the furtherance of the gospel. Ngayon, my dear brothers and sisters, the truth of the gospel. God wants us to know the truth. God wants us to be saved. And we should not be confused of many false teaching about salvation. Salvation is only through the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ is the Son of God. He is sinless. He shed his blood on the cross. He suffered. He died and he was buried. And the third day he rose again that we can have salvation. Salvation is the free gift. That's why we can have it. If you are not yet saved, you must receive the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Receive him as your personal savior. The truth of the gospel review. First of all, salvation comes by receiving the gospel. Number two, the truth of the gospel, the lost needs to hear the gospel. Number three, about the truth of the gospel, saved people or Christians are responsible to proclaim the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you. Good evening.